Good morning, everyone. It's great to see everybody. I want to thank everyone at NYRAC for the kind invitation to come this morning to talk about fair housing. My name is Michael Romer. I'm the managing partner of Romer Debbas. We are a law firm based in Midtown Manhattan, focused on residential purchases and sales in New York City. And I've been asked today to come and speak about fair housing, and most importantly, the new regulations that are about to go live. And let me be clear, these are going live June 20th. Now, what am I referring to specifically? Effective June 20th, the New York Department of State is requiring that a fair housing notice, and the form has been circulated, that a fair housing notice be displayed at all physical and virtual open houses, be displayed in brokerage offices, and a link to the form being displayed on all agent and broker websites. In addition, the state has come out with a disclosure form, very similar to the agency disclosure form, in that this form needs to be signed off by prospective clients at the point of first substantive contact. So at the very beginning of your relationship, you need to have two forms now signed, the agency disclosure form and the fair housing disclosure form. And I've circulated the fair housing form as well. Now, where did all this come from? Why are we doing this and why is this necessary? As many of you paid attention out in Long Island, there was a Newsday investigation with respect to alleged discrimination in the real estate market. And the allegations out there really were centered around the concept of steering. Now, steering is a curse word in fair housing circles because you as agents and brokers should not be, you know, pointing clients in a particular direction based on any protected characteristic. Now, protected characteristics in New York State include race, color, creed, religion. So at the end of the day, it doesn't matter what you look like or what God you pray to or where you come from. You know, that where that person ends up living, those characteristics really should have no place in the process. So at the end of the day, that investigation turned up some troubling things in terms of agents out in Long Island basically steering people of color to certain neighborhoods that were predominantly filled with people of color. And this was really troubling. And in some cases, the allegations are that these acts of discrimination were intentional and in some cases unintentional. And at the end of the day here in New York City, my main concern is to protect you, the individual agents, especially agents like yourselves who've been doing deals for a long time and, you know, have a great reputation. You never want to be associated with discrimination. So it's really important to understand that fair housing applies to everything that we do. So when you're selling a piece of property or when you're showing a buyer potential properties to look at, you really need to be careful so that you're not offending the person or potentially offending the person. So to specify, the fair housing notice makes clear a few key points. One, refusing to rent, sell, or show a property based on a potential tenant or purchaser's protected characteristic. Quoting a higher price to a purchaser or renter because of the potential purchaser or tenant's characteristic, refusing to rent to a tenant who has children, or increasing a security deposit based on the number of children who will be living in the apartment, steering, remember, curse word, prospective tenants or purchasers to certain neighborhoods based on any protected characteristics, refusing to rent to a potential tenant because of their source of income, including but not limited to Section 8 vouchers or other government subsidies, refusing to waive a no pet policy for tenants that require a service assistant or emotional support animal, discriminating at the direction of a seller or a landlord, or because it is the preference of a seller or landlord. Bear in mind, you are responsible if you help a client accomplish a discriminatory goal. And finally, refusing to rent to a renter who is a victim of domestic violence. Now, the state made clear that these are instances of fair housing violations, and now this notice is now public. So for consumer protection, all potential buyers and sellers now know what discrimination is if they didn't know what it was before. And this all stems from that Newsday investigation. Now, look, as many of you have been to my fair housing classes in the past, I do believe that New York State is the gold standard for fair housing in the country and that the rest of the country has some catching up. And this is just an instance of the state stepping in to make sure that the public at large knows that they take fair housing and discrimination very seriously, and so should we. Thanks, everybody.